In this video, I'm going to introduce you to the fundamental algorithm of a neural network's convolutional layer. I want you to focus on the concepts, not the calculation, so I'm not going to use any math. Instead, let's just open up a layer and watch it in action. We'll look at a two-dimensional convolution, since those are the most common to see in practice. This means that our input and output will have two spatial dimensions and one feature dimension. We call this type of tensor a feature map. It's made up of floating point numbers, but since I don't want you to think about the numbers or the math in this video, I'll show a cube in each number's place. All right, let's look inside the layer. Here we can see the weights of the layer. These weights are normally stored in a single four-dimensional tensor, but I've broken them up into several three-dimensional tensors to make them easier to visualize. And this isn't just my convention. The industry has a name for these parts of the weights. Filters. The values of the filters control the output. The training process adjusts these values to make the network's output more correct. Now let's look at how the convolutional algorithm combines the filters with the input. This is really what makes the convolutional layer different from other layers. Conceptually, we work with one filter at a time. To compute a single output value, we look at a patch of the input underneath the filter window. In this case, we're looking at a 3x3 area of pixels. We use this patch and the filter to compute the output. Again, don't worry about the math for now. I'll cover that in detail in another video. Instead, think of the filter as containing a specific pattern, and the output value as corresponding to how well the input matched that pattern. A shallow layer in the network might be looking for a certain color or an edge, and a deeper layer might be looking for a dog or a face or a dog's face. After computing the value for this patch, we move on to the next patch and repeat the same calculation for our next output value. We continue this pattern to calculate the rest of the output values in this row. Then, we move down to a new row in both the input and the output, and we repeat everything we've done so far for this new row. We continue this row after row until we've covered the whole input spatially. Now we've completed one feature of the output. Let's watch that again, because this is what makes convolution so special. At each step, we examine a small local patch of the input. This makes convolution great for data where nearby information is related. And we repeat the same calculation over the whole input. This makes convolution computationally efficient and reduces the number of parameters in the network. This is great for any data that's structured spatially, such as audio, images, and video. Now, so far, we've only used one filter. Note that this filter corresponds to this feature of the output. And I've given this feature of the output the same color as the filter to help make that more clear. Now, let's move on to the next filter. We repeat the entire process with this new filter to form the next feature of the output. We do this for every filter to form all of the features of the output. Take a moment to watch this and really let the relationship between the input, the filters, and the output sink in. Now we've completed our output. And that wraps up the fundamental algorithm. In future videos, I'll comprehensively cover the options and variations of convolution. So, subscribe if you want to see more.